still making a buzz now on ABC 15, that video of a school bus monitor being brutally teased and abused by a group of boys. Katrina Schaefer brought you the story yesterday, and since then, Karen Klein, the bus monitor from Rochester, New York, has gotten a ton of support online. A website set up to raise money to send Karen on a vacation has now ballooned to more than $320,000. As for the boys involved, they've even gotten death threats after their names and addresses were posted online. With so many people still talking about this story, we wanted to give you a chance to sound off. What do you think about what happened on that bus? And what should happen to the students involved? And how about the subsequent outpouring of support for Karen?
Yeah, we're just hearing it's over $340,000.
Oh, $340,000 now. Yeah. Boy, it changes instantly.
Yeah, Matt McAllister from the Ben and Matt Show on KNIX joining us. And you talked to Karen's son today.
Yeah.
We were watching the ticker. Every minute it was going up like $1,000.
Unbelievable.
Is he surprised that his mom is getting so much love?
Oh, absolutely. And our first question was how, it was hard enough to watch for all of us.
Oh, no question.
But how is it to watch your mom getting abused like that by, they look like 13-year-old
kids.
He just said it was extremely difficult, and he didn't even know about it until it made the news. So that led us to believe that this is a daily occurrence on this bus, that this poor lady for $15,000 a year is riding around being harassed like that pretty much every day.
And you know, these guys, these young boys on the bus, they all came forward after the incident was put online and went viral. Mm-hmm. And you know, they apologized. Is that enough? I mean, you know, a lot of the parents maybe didn't even know their sons were doing this and possibly could be a bully. But as a parent, where do you draw the line?
Well, you know, it's your worst nightmare as a parent to see a video like that and then all of a sudden realize, oh, wait, that's my kid's school.
Right.
There's my kid being a part of that. But, you know, there was something vaguely familiar about watching that video. And that was those memories of me as a kid riding the bus, and as kids, maybe there was like one kid, and everybody would start to make fun of the one kid, and then there's that pack mentality that starts. And I can't sit here and tell you that I never participated in that. Never against an adult, of course, but it was so familiar to me, I immediately became embarrassed about maybe some things I did as a kid and maybe participating in some bullying. So I think an apology in this case is okay, because they're kids.
Yeah. Well, to set the scene for some people who may not have seen this, it's about, the video is about 10 minutes long. This woman is sitting on your standard bus seat. You see her right there, and she is taking a verbal beating. I'm telling you, the kids are talking about they want to beat her up. They said that they want to kill her. They're making fun of her weight. They are throwing everything they can at her, and you know what? She didn't say a word back. Mm-mm. I would have wanted to slap the kids.
Yeah.
That's just me. And I don't know if I would have had to.
Yeah, you see her
if the bus needed to pull over to the side and me get off so I could gather my thoughts. I applaud her. And then you spoke to her son as we circle back to you now. What did he say about seeing his mom taking this kind of punishment?
Well, he was glad to see that this fund that was supposed to be about $5,000 had ballooned to $300,000. And I think he was hoping to maybe get a little chunk.
I think he's going to start calling a whole lot more. They're going to go to dinner for sure. And it's really tough, though, as you said, as a parent, when you finally see this video and see that your child is associated with it. It's heartbreaking.
It is.
As a parent, because you think you're doing the right thing. And so many of you agree on our Facebook page. Robin Arasso says all those students need to be suspended for bullying, and the bus driver should have consequences as well. This never should have happened. That whole school needs a seminar on bullying. My heart breaks for this woman.
I agree with Robin. Tova writes in, my children would be made to walk to and from school the rest of the year if they did that. Uphill both ways. Put it on there.
In the snow.
Jill Henrichsen says, we need to bring those bullies here. Give them sunblock, water, and hats, and have them pick up trash along our Phoenix area roads and highways every day from noon to 5 when it's at the hottest.
Wow. And Mary sharing her thoughts as well, saying, I think there's some overreaction happening. Why are people donating money to this elderly woman? What does that have to do with bullying? If you want to donate money, donate it to a charity that needs the money, perhaps something to do with the elderly and or educating people such as children on bullying.
Well, Mary, they were hoping to give her a vacation.
Okay.
And they were only hoping to raise $5,000. And it just kept going up because of the generosity of so many people who saw this. The question that Sean and I, the producer, had was, how does she get this money? How is Karen actually going to get this money from this fund that's on a Facebook page?
That's really
that
is a good question.
Maybe someone will just mail her a ticket to Tahiti or something. I don't know. But
we also got a call from a principal because Ben on our show had a great question. He said, how did this go on for so long? Why wasn't there a video camera? Because you see surveillance videos now.
Yeah.
And we had a principal from Ahwatukee call in and said, just want to let everybody know here in the Valley that in all of our districts in this part of the Valley, we have cameras and we do monitor buses.
Oh,
and if we see one incident like this, the kid's gone for the year.
There
they're never
go.
Allowed it. So I think that sort of restored our faith
yes.
in
That's great.
The
Zero
bus
tolerance.
System anyway.
And
yeah.
bullying
Zero
is
tolerance.
Such a problem that needs to be addressed
yeah.
nationwide.
And thankfully, a student on that bus got out the camera and started recording it.
Yeah.
So.